There's nobody lives on the island now. It's mostly a bird sanctuary. The last time we were over was 2013, and we brought over 2,000 tonnes of granite from the island. It's a neck of a volcano that's left of an ancient volcano that cooled very quickly, hence the reason the two different types of granite that's on the island. We manufacture culling stones for the whole world, Canada, Korea, Russia, all over the world. All the Olympic stones, I think there's six sets that we have made for the Olympics. Even an advert, they're using our stones for Specsavers, strangely enough. I'm Jim Bryce and I'm the factory manager. I've been doing this for a year and 3 months. I bought the machines that you've seen through the back, and I just phoned down on the off chance to see if there was any work, and I got the job. We go down to Girvan where we store the boulders, and we mark up the boulders with a number. They are then picked up and transferred up to Aberdeen, where they're cut into slabs. We mark up as many cheeses as we can out of that slab, depending on the size of the slab, and we core them out. Once they're cored, they're then quality checked to make sure there's no flaws in them, like you see in these ones here. A recess is placed in them to insert the ilsert, the blue hone, which becomes the rounding edge of the culling stone. Once that's done, they're rough shaped, and then they're fine shaped, and then they're polished by hand. We've got 14 people here. Well, we're producing about 8 a day, so about an hour, just slightly over an hour. What's good about it is it's giving the guys a bit of ownership throughout the whole process. I feel, in my experience in management, makes the quality a lot better. They take a bit of pride in their work. We're manufacturing the whole year round, and even in between the period of the Olympics and Winter Olympics and stuff, the Commonwealth Games, we're still manufacturing every day, every week.